General Piet Burger, the Director of Helicopter Services at the South African Air Force. He was to testify, amongst other things, on the use of the helicopters acquired through the strategic procurement packages, including missions that they have been involved in and accidents. For the latest, we are joined by SABC reporter Njanji Chowke. Njanji, can you tell us the latest there at the arms deal?
Yes, drama this morning as we arrived here at the Arms Commission hearing. As we got here, most of the media people had to be turned back because Judge Siriti was witnessing that the building is getting flooded. There was water that was seeping through the walls. And for him, he said that it's a health hazard and it's not worth it. It's not safe, actually, for the commission to sit today. As I speak to you now, documents are still being removed from this building. As you know, that we have millions and millions of pages in crucial evidence that has been submitted by various whistleblowers as well as other stakeholders in the commission. But to tell us a bit more about what has really happened a short while ago is the commission spokesperson, Mr. William Baloyi. Mr. Baloyi, can you just tell us what happened a short while ago and why was there a need for the commission to be adjourned?
I think the chairperson took a decision of adjourning the hearings after the area was seriously flooded. We suspect maybe there might be a pipe that has burst, and we thought that it's going to endanger the lives of the people around, but also the documentation, so that it should not be destroyed. But also it activated the alarm system, which went off, and there was noise all over, but also the water was also increasing in terms of the volume of the flow. And as such, we took a decision that the chairperson communicated that the hearing should be postponed until tomorrow.
We saw an urgent mopping up operation in some of the offices there. And we know that there's very sensitive documents that are being brought here every morning. Are there some of those documents, were they damaged by any chance?
Fortunately, no documents were damaged, and we have taken all precautionary measures to make sure that they are secured. As you see that the police are enforced here, they are checking that as the mopping operation continues, nothing happens to the documents. But the most sensitive ones have been taken by the security forces to make sure that they are very safe. And we'll be guided by the city's engineers as to when the building will be safe to be used again.
Okay. And then can you just tell us in terms of how is this going to affect the commission? The commission was proceeding very well after a number of delays.
Obviously, this affects the times that we do have, but fortunately, the evidence leaders and the witnesses have saw this before. So they made sure that we have an extra week put within the list of the hearings. So safely, we are still within time.
Maybe just to put it on record, we understand that it's not only this building that has been affected. To say that it looks like a number of places in the center, some people also saying the underground parking water is seeping through as well.
Actually, the whole center is affected. Also at the parking, underground parking, as you have said, there is a lot of water there, but also the water has been cut off, water supply to the whole building, so that they fix the problem. So obviously, it's going to be a health hazard if we can try to continue when the water has been cut, and also as a precautionary to make sure that we avoid any damage that might come out of the effect of the water. As you know, that it might affect the electrical systems and any other system that is around here.
There you have it from the Arms Commission spokesperson, Mr. William Baloyi. So that's what has happened this morning, and then they're hoping that the proceedings will resume early tomorrow. We will be bringing you the story as it unfolds. We will be here until later this afternoon. It's back to you in studio.